Alright, here we go. Another planting video. Last field that we have left to plant. Just planting a more wheat. We planted we planted 31, which is about 55 hectares, roughly. Maybe under an hour, 45 minutes. On and off. Now we're just planting 32 here with more wheat. Have a lot of spraying to do. Gonna get my follow me helper up and running. T9565 running Telborg doubles. And we got the T9700 and T97 over here with ATI track system. I always love this map when it's around the evenings or mornings. So we'll just get busy with this field. We'll work our way back. Just do a headland. Set up our GPS on the way back. And this is the last field of. We have a lot of corn planted. We have a lot of soybean planted. We had no wheat, so we had one field of barley. So we're just trying to get a variety of crops. It's mostly corn and soybean, though, with the addition of these fields, just enormous amount of wheat will come out of here. So we're laying down fertilizer again, so it's all going to be fertilized wheat. We have soybeans that need to be harvested again. So we initially started planting a headland here when we were planting 31. I was just gonna do it in one big loop, and then I just kinda ended up just planting the other field. Because I kind of forgot that I was going to do that, but whatever. So this will be a little bit tricky with these planters here, this area over here. So this isn't that big of a field in all reality. It's a 45 hectares, maybe. See, it's a pretty standard sized field on this map. Nothing special about it. It's kind of hilly. Has a few obstacles. Nothing too major. Just hope my follow me mod can make it through, maneuver around this. These wind turbines. If I miss a little, no big deal. Want to purchase this 37 right here. It's a beautiful, beautiful field. So what I'm going to end up doing is bringing out my HUD hider again and just scooching over my GPS just a little. And then I'm going to rename this 32. So load up course 30, slot 32, and save it there. Save it as 32. Now we're in business. So Jake hopped on here earlier and took care of the rest of my beets. We had a great demand going for sugar beets, so he just unloaded whatever it was. It was probably close to, you know, 250,000 liters of beets that we sold, so we have a pretty decent amount of money now. However, our herbicide operation is going to put a pretty decent dent in our budget. We're probably going to go through $100,000. Dollars worth of herbicide on these fields, if not more. Can get about 20 hectares per tank, maybe a little bit less depending on how many obstacles. So that's that. We have a lot of weeds to spray around here. Should really take out the cultivator, the lumpkin, and square up some of these edges, but not too worried. So over here you can see that I have buyable objects. You can buy the small little grain, you can buy this brown shed, and that way you're not just saving to purchase fields, you can actually buy buildings and objects. So I didn't plan this too well, but oh well. lose my... Nope, he's still there. So I may be running the wrong route course for this, but then we gotta go all the way back down. Ideally, I should have started where I did it initially before I forgot. So, it was a snow day today, and a snow day tomorrow, which is pretty cool. Don't think it's ever happened before. I think here in Boston, we got 60 inches in the last 30 days, and like 42 in the past week, so it's pretty snowy around here. So I'm just trying to, I'm on my grain farm save game, just because I want to play with some big machinery. I have a dairy game where I'm on that farm over there, the modern white dairy farm, and I have a lot of alfalfa to mow and to windrow and to bale, and have a lot of bales already baled, have some straw, so... Need to invest in a better mixing operation. Tried working on a feeder truck and it didn't really work. It's like I don't know what's going on. It like the nodes will rotate, the noises will turn on, it will load, it will mix, but it won't unload into the troughs. So I'm not really sure what to make of it. So that's his line, then he's gonna go down this one, so my line is right here. I was thinking of making a triple tire version of this. So I can run one with tracks and one with triples. Get, trade off the T95 and get another T97 with triples. And probably get another combine while I'm at it for our harvest. Need another draper and another combine, and we should be good to go. You know the map is big when you're running two planters this size. And planted 39, 38, 22, 40. Basically, this whole north left part of the map, and then 32 and 33. Never planted 19. That's just ready to harvest. So once that's done, I'm gonna have to plant that again, but it literally would take, if you were to sit at the computer and plant these fields, it would probably take 6 to 7 hours, if not longer, to plant everything we've planted with these two planters. So, between 19, 32, 31, 33, 43, 42, 41, 40, 22, 38, 39, I really want to get 37. It's a lot. To give you an example, field 33 is 75 hectares, 31 is 55, 32 is 40 or something, 19 is 45. 41 was like 18, 40 was like 30. I don't know. That's an enormous amount of land that we're farming right now. And it goes pretty quick, though. I can't imagine trying to plant with the in-game equipment. I mean, it would take forever. So this is crazy. We just need to fix this terrain a little bit. But playing the map and playing the map on multiplayer allows you to cover a lot of ground and allows you to find all the errors and stuff that needs to be fixed or adjusted. So when you're making a map hilly and not straight, you can have some pretty sharp inclines, drops. So that's him again. And this one's me. So besides next to that road, because this course is paralleled from the railroad track, the road that goes from the parallel track, because 31 is both sides are parallel with one another, so that's what the GPS course was based off. That way we can go the long way, and I'll just wait for my course play guy to catch up. So this tractor doesn't have very many hours on it. 18 hours. Traded off some of the T8. tractors. One of the T8s had like 65 or 70 hours on it. So that one had a lot of game time on it. I think we decided to trade in equipment once it hits 50 hours, maybe 70 or something like that. Too bad the equipment doesn't depreciate with more hours you put on it. You know, like basically you buy it and the price is cut in half once you buy it. But it'd be nice if it actually had a depreciation per like amount of hours or miles or whatever. Threshing hours for a combine or odometer hours, you know, mileage. It'd be nice if that actually figured into the price for resale, but it doesn't. Or if you could buy used equipment, that would be really cool. Instead of buying everything brand new. If you could buy used equipment. The exhaust on this thing is so big, it's awesome, and I like the bigger hood now. Looks like a real T97. Making quick work of this another field. Planting's easy. Not looking forward to spraying all these weeds or harvesting. Harvesting's probably gonna be like a 2-weekend deal on multiplayer. Unless you run course play the whole time. I was helping Jake on his game and he... The jerk made me plant this field with a 12 meter. 12 meter planer by myself. It took like an hour. Haven't helped him since.